Thunder wolves are unique to space wolves and a great addition to the army. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to paint the wolf. Now, I'm not going to show you how to do the space marine because we've already got a video on how to do those. But the techniques here are going to be useful to you because pelts feature prominently throughout the space wolf army. So go and get your paints and we can begin. The first thing to do with any model once you've finished building it is to give it an undercoat, and in this case I've gone for Chaos Black Spray. And you'll notice I've not put the rider on, and that's because with cavalry models it's much easier to paint the rider and the mount separately and glue them together at the end. Now the first thing I'm going to be doing on the model is apply a base coat to start out with, and I'm going to go for Dryad Bark with this one. Now you've got a lot of options here really, you could go for greys or black or other browns if you wanted to, but Dryad Bark's a very good starting point. Now as always, give the paint a good shake. And the brush I'm going to be using to apply this is a large brush. And this first stage is, well, it's pretty straightforward this is. Get a good amount of paint on your palette. I'm going to thin it down with just a small amount of water, just so that the paint runs a bit easier onto the model and will dry smoother. And when you're ready, you just need to paint this all over your wolf. So I'm going to be making sure that I really work it in amongst the fur, just like this, to get a good even coating. And once you're done with this, we can move on to the next stage and start brightening it up. Now I've finished base coating the brown, I've got a really good starting point for applying my pattern. Now, once again, it's really up to you exactly how you do this pattern, but I'm going to be starting out by painting Gorthor brown. This is going to go on the muzzle of the wolf, then on its paws, and also along its belly underneath. Now, I'm going to be applying this using a standard brush, and this stage you don't need to be particularly neat for a whole lot of it. Around the fur you can be fairly rough. So once your paint's ready, what I mean is I'm looking like underneath the belly, kind of down here. I'm just going to roughly start painting this in the kind of area that I want to be this lighter colour. But as I get to the face, I have to be a bit more careful. Around here, because the detail's smoother here, I've got to paint in the direction of how the fur runs along his face. So kind of like this. You see I'm following the direction of how it's growing along there. So it's just a case now of putting this brown on in all the places you want to be a lighter brown. And of course, if you want to do a different colour, then it's up to you to start applying them in whatever pattern that you want to have. Now that I've finished the Gorthor brown, you can see the pattern starting to appear. But the next thing I'm going to do is to apply an extra highlight on the face, and that's because faces on miniatures are the focal point. So if I make it a bit lighter, then it's really going to stand out. The colour I'm going to use for this is Baneblade brown, and I'm still applying it using the standard brush. And I'm going to be doing this in the same kind of way that I did the Gorthor brown earlier on the muzzle. So once the paint's ready, I'm going to be applying this, once again, following the direction of the fur. Now, I'm going to be leaving the Gorthor brown showing in all the recesses. So these wrinkles around the mouth here, I'm just going to be working around those just to really accentuate those raised surfaces and start to bring that detail of the mouth out. So I'm just going to be doing this now, but only on the parts that I've already done with Gorthor brown just around here. So with that highlight applied, you can see the face now just stands out a bit more from the rest of the body. The next thing I'm going to do is going to be the final part of the pattern. For this, I'm going to be applying Abaddon Black, and I'm going to be doing it as a stripe running down the wolf's back. But once again, if you wanted to change the colour for this part, then you can do, of course. Now I'll be applying this again using my standard brush, and the application is going to be just the same as when I was doing the Gorthor brown earlier. So I'm going to be starting just behind the wolf's head, just around about here. And it's just a case of doing quite a rough line, running all the way down to the tail. Now I've finished the black stripe, and I'm happy with the pattern now. I can move on to the next step, which is to start bringing all of these different colours together. Now the first stage for doing this is to do a dry brush across the whole miniature, and you need Terminator Stone for it. I'm going to be applying it using a medium dry brush, and the technique is to get a small amount on the bristles of your brush, and get some tissue, and use the tissue to start working the paint in amongst the bristles and also getting rid of any excess paint, because you don't want very much on your brush here. Now, when your brush is looking kind of like that, you're ready to begin. So what you do is get your model and just start flicking this colour lightly back and forth over the fur, and you'll see very quickly it starts catching on all that coarse detail and really bringing it out. Now, as you go across all the different colours, this will start to bring them all together. So you need to do it across the whole miniature, and that does include the face. And when you're going over the face, just make sure to angle your brush so that you're going over those lines of the creases down there. See how at this angle, they're really starting to pop out. So with the dry brushing finished, you can see it's had a really nice effect on the pelt. It's really brought out all the shape of the fur. And you could leave it here, of course, if you wanted to, but I want to go a bit further and add some more depth to it. So for this, I'm going to be applying a shade across the entire miniature now, and I'm going to use Agrax Earthshade for it. You could use different colours again if you wanted to, like Norn Oil is a good one, but I'm also going to be diluting this with Lamian Medium. This will give a smoother finish than water would if I mixed it with water. Word of advice, if you're going to be diluting a paint with medium, make sure that you wash your brush before you start picking any up, or else you can contaminate the medium with colour. So get your mix together, and I'm using a wash brush to apply this. I'm going to be applying this across all of the model, and you'll see as I put it on, it starts settling in amongst all the little recesses in the fur and gives some really nice shading to them. So I'm going to paint this across the whole model now and give it plenty of time to dry. When the shade is dry, the next thing to do is to apply a light dry brush with Terminator's Stone once again, but this time focusing just on the raised surfaces and following the muscles. So I'm leaving a dark line there, you see, and then picking out this part. And this really accentuates the shape of the body and the muscles. So you need to work around your model doing this just very gently and just picking out all these surfaces. But when you get around to doing the muzzle, you just need to, well, once again, very lightly dry brush just across the creases on top of the face, just like I'm doing here. With the final dry brush done, the pelt is now complete. And as you can see, this technique works really well, so it's very useful on Space Wolves for doing all the different decorations on them too, so the pelts hanging from their vehicles and their armour, for example. Now, as I've been saying since the start, you can vary the colours as much as you like to create all kinds of different patterns, and the box art can give you some really good ideas for which colours to use for this. But now that the main pelt's done, I'm going to work on all the details, and the first of those are going to be the eyes. Now my wolf's only got one organic eye left, so you need to paint both of these in the same way on yours if it's still got both eyes. You need Avalanche Sunset for the first colour, and the second colour is going to be Abaddon Black for the pupil. Now the most important thing here is to keep a steady hand, so it might help you to brace your hands right down on the table to do this. But when you get your paint ready, use a fine detail brush and get a really nice tip on the bristles. Then when you're ready, what you're looking to do is take advantage of the fact that the eye's already been shaded and just paint a line of yellow in the very middle of it. So as neatly as you can, just a small amount of yellow just there. Once that's done, the next step is to get a small amount of Abaddon Black and with your fine detail brush, just paint a bit in the front corner of the eye. Just like that. Now it really helps to thin your paint down a little bit with water at this stage so that it flows easily onto the model when you're painting it on. So now the eye is finished, and also by the way, make sure you paint the nose black at the same time, seeing as you got the Abaddon Black out. But once that's done, the next thing to paint is the gums and the tongue, and for this you only need two colours. We're going to first of all do a base coat of Screamer Pink, and then we're going to layer it using Pink Horror. And for both these colours, I'm going to be using the fine detail brush again. And like painting the eye, you just need to make sure that you get that good tip on your brush and that you thin the paint down with a little bit of water to help it flow better. So when you're painting it onto the gums, it's a very thin line between the teeth and the muzzle. Now you can go over the teeth at this point because we've not painted them yet, but be as neat as you can so as not to get any of this pink on the muzzle. And then with Pink Horror, and of course a fine tip on your brush, just apply a highlight on the gum wherever it meets the base of a tooth. So just in small areas, just running along the length of it. Just like that. Now, when you come to doing the tongue, instead, do a line highlight running around the very edge of it. Now we've finished with those two colours, the gums and the tongue are now finished, and in fact there's not really much more left to go. The next thing I'm going to paint are the teeth and the claws, and for doing these parts you need four colours. I'm going to start with a base coat of Xandri Dust, then I'll shade these areas using Agrax Earthshade. After that I'm going to layer them using the Shabti Bone, and then finally add a highlight with Screaming Skull. So for the Xandri Dust I'm going to be applying this using a detail brush, and you just need to get your paint ready, just as we've been doing before. As you're applying this, just be careful, especially in the mouth, that you don't get this paint on the gums and on the tongue as well too. Actually, it can be a little bit tricky working around it, so take your time. I find it easiest to paint in this angle to work up the tooth, like I'm doing here. So yeah, you just need to do this for the teeth and for the claws. Next, apply a shade of Agrax Earthshade over these areas, but just take the time to aim the shade more towards the base of the teeth and the claws. When the shade is dry, the next step is to apply some ushabti bone with your fine detail brush along the length of the tooth or the claw. So just like this, leaving the darker colour showing at the base of the tooth and the claw. And then finally, just add a highlighted screaming skull just on the very tips of these parts. You don't need very much, just a small amount, just where it's sharpest. Now, once you've done this, there'll be a couple of extra bits and pieces on your wolf to paint, things like bionics and armour. Now, for a guide of how to do those, check out our Grey Hunter guide. That covers all the information, the techniques and paints that you need to be able to paint those parts. And there it is, the Thunderwolf is now complete. And as you've seen, doing this method really is very straightforward, and it hasn't taken me very long to do either. Now, when you're painting a Thunderwolf, remember the easiest way to do it, first of all, is to put in your pattern. And you can be quite rough at this stage and pick whatever colours you want. But once you've done that, apply a dry brush, then a shade, and then a dry brush. And doing those three steps will really bring all those colours together. Finally, once you finish this part, you just need to add all the details. And throughout that whole process, just be as neat as you possibly can.